My name is Rita Tamayo. I'm an assistant professor here at the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill in the Department of Microbiology and Immunology. We study two bacterial pathogens that cause intestinal disease, and we use biochemical and genetic tools to understand how they are able to cause disease. So I grew up in Houston, Texas. My parents are both from Mexico, and you know, they always reminded me that I could have more and do better if I went to college and then get a job that would provide more. So my earliest interests, real interests in science, started with a chemistry course that I took in high school. Mr. Gallery was the instructor, and he had a way of using really good metaphors to make things understandable. And it wasn't until I really saw what it meant to be a scientist when I did a work study job in a lab, you know, the day-to-day ins and outs of being a scientist and how you have to think and the types of interactions that you have and the fact that you get to ultimately pursue the kinds of questions that you personally are interested in. My lab focuses on two bacteria that cause disease in humans. They're both intestinal pathogens, which means that they cause a diarrheal disease. One of them is called Vibrio cholera. It causes the disease cholera, which is a profuse diarrheal disease. It's really dangerous because of how quickly it can cause death because of dehydration, you know, within 24 to 48 hours. It's really severe. It's primarily an issue in areas of the world where there's poor sanitation and lack of access to clean drinking water. The other organism that we started working on a few years ago is called Clostridium difficile, which you may have seen as C. diff for short in the news. And it's actually a really big problem in the US and in other places where we rely heavily on antibiotics to treat infections. And the reason for that is that the antibiotics change the composition of the healthy bacteria in the intestine, which are usually protective against C. diff, in a way that now C. diff can grow and cause disease. C. difficile is an obligate anaerobe. That means that the actively growing form of the bacteria are really sensitive to oxygen. They don't survive outside the body in the presence of oxygen. It doesn't do a good job of killing them off. But ultimately, these bacteria end up in the large intestine. And the large intestine is anaerobic, so there's no oxygen there to kill off these cells. And this is where these bacteria start to produce toxins that basically kill off cells in the intestine. And so in that process, they damage the tissue, which leads to a lot of inflammation. And that also breaks up the barrier of the intestine so that there's leakage of fluids into the intestine, and that's what causes the diarrheal disease. Standard microscopy, you know, you have to bring your samples out to the microscope, and you know, there's oxygen around, so that'll kill the C. diff bacteria. And so we've been working on developing little devices that can maintain the anaerobic conditions that the bacteria need for long periods so that we can bring the bacteria out within these devices and then take them to the microscope and do high resolution live imaging.
So Aaron wants to look at some samples by microscopy, and so one of the tricks that we can use just for quick looks at our bacteria is to put them on a slide and then put a cover slip on top. It's pretty standard, and then actually just seal them in with nail polish, and so that creates enough of a seal that for at least, you know, a short amount of time, those samples can be preserved.
And I'm occasionally in the lab doing experiments still. That's becoming more and more rare as I take on more people and have more writing and other commitments. I have more of a supervisory role. I touch base with the lab, usually on a daily basis, just to see how things are going, whether there's any new data. If an experiment has succeeded, then great, what do we do next? If it's failed, then what can we change about the experiment, if anything, to to hopefully make it work better.
This is it's called an HPLC. We want to detect a small molecule that we're interested in our bacteria. Tony uses this kind of methods for some of his studies, so we're just trying to adopt them. We should get some each of these lines represents an assay in this experiment. Obviously, there are a lot of measurements that we did in this experiment, so we can go back and figure out what each of these lines corresponds to, and then interpret those results.
I am never, ever lonely here. It's constant conversations to the point where sometimes I have to close my door if I'm gonna get anything done. You know, these are a bunch of enthusiastic people, right? And so between people in my lab coming with, hey, you know, I just got this piece of data, what do you think? To other investigators from other labs stopping by with ideas and questions. It is far from lonely. I love the fact that I'm able to help train enthusiastic junior scientists, and, you know, I learn a lot from them too. We study two organisms that, you know, separately affect different populations in the world, and really cause a lot of disease and a lot of deaths and discomfort and pain. So to be able to alleviate that in the long term is one of our ultimate goals. Do what you are interested in doing, answer the questions that you want to answer. Things can fall into place. Ask for help when you need it, ask tons of questions, seek people's opinions. It really is beneficial to find someone who does what you think you want to do and ask them all the hard questions. Do they like it? What do they like about it? What do they not like about it? And see how that fits in with what you think you want to do.